two separate words.
Yes.
Even though one, both of them help each other, but they're two separate words. One has to do with output, and one has to do with the inner you. So I guess if you're a person of integrity, you will by all means want to work with excellence, because integrity actually means being whole, being undivided, being a person of truth and character. And excellence also means doing your very best, giving it your distinctive best. It has to be marvelous, it has to be matchless, whatever you're trying to do. So if you put those two together, then I would say that a person of integrity believes in excellence in whatever they do. That's how I'll put it. Well, I'm very, very, how shall I put it? I am very committed to those two virtues, for the simple reason that I believe that God lives in me because I'm a Christian. And if God lives in me, then the only thing that can come out of me are the characteristics of God. And God is a God of truth. God is a God of undivided holiness and excellence. I mean, I look at nature and I see the total excellence in nature and the way things work. And so I'm passionate about those two words. And I really strive to let both words work in my life. My favorite quote on integrity is doing what is right even when no one is looking. I think it sums it up. And when it comes to excellence, I always say my best quote is something I coined myself: be the best you can be. Because excellence is not really about trying to compare yourself to another person, but excellence means doing the very best you know you can to make what you're doing stand out. Whatever your hands find to do, you must do the best you can. Because I think it's very pathetic and undignifying if you practice mediocrity. When you practice mediocrity, it means that you're just doing your minimum. Anything goes. And really, life is not like that. Let's take something in nature. Let's take air. We all want real, pure oxygen to breathe. And if it turned out that one day God decided that He will not give us the pure oxygen, and that He will just give us a mixture of anything, then none of us is going to survive. And so for me, doing things with excellence is really what it ought to be. That's what it ought to be. And again, if you go into nature, you know, when you put food in your mouth, and you spend your time to either swallow it or chew it so that it can go inside your body and perform what it has to perform. Now, if you didn't do that, you wouldn't get the best out of the food, and your body will not turn out right. So when I look at these very basic things, you know, then you know that excellence actually is a must for everybody, and we must encourage all people to be people of excellence. Anything good comes with a price. If you take an athlete, I am sure if we found Usain Bolt and we asked him how he's so excellent, he will tell you what he has to do to get there, the training he has to do, the tiredness he has to overcome. Because I'm told by athletes that it gets to a stage where your knees are even giving way under you, but you know you have to go on. So it means that you stretch yourself beyond the normal. And success is like that. You don't succeed merely by doing the minimum. And if you want to do the maximum, even the word maximum shows that you have to go beyond what is the bottom line, what is the basic. So it comes at a cost, but it is worth it. It is worth the price you pay to really succeed and to sustain the success. You know, some people succeed and within a short time, that success is blown out into thin air because of the lack of consistency in maintaining being the best. Again, it's not competitiveness. It is about maintaining what you know is good and continuing to maintain it. I believe that life, which is ordinary, is very unfulfilling. And I think that we were created to have maximum fulfillment in life. Everything in nature shows it. If you put a seed in the ground, its optimum is to bear fruit. Think about corn. You put a corn seed, and the corn seed struggles and wriggles, you know, against all odds. But what joy when you can find a cob and you can pluck it and use it. I think that's what life is about. You know, we are supposed to bear fruit. We are supposed to show what we are made of, you know. And not to do that would be to truncate our own lives. It's like you began, but you didn't complete it. What I'd like to say to Christians is that to be a Christian actually means to have Christ living in you by His Spirit. And we find this in Romans 8 and verse 9. To be a Christian also means to love the Lord Jesus and to show your love by being obedient to Him. To be a Christian also means following in the footsteps of the Lord Jesus Christ, learning from Him. When you go to Matthew 28 and 20, the Lord Jesus says, we make disciples of all nations in verse 19, and then we teach them to obey everything He has taught us. So being a Christian means obeying what God says we should do. And so wherever you are, especially in the corporate environment, ask yourself, what would Jesus do sitting in your chair? What would He do? Would He fight the figures? Would He mistreat those that He works with? Would He cover up? Would He want to get the best for Himself at the expense of others? Would He make Himself more important than the company? These are questions we should ask. That is what I'd like to tell corporate people. Ask the simple question, what would Jesus do if He sat in my chair? And then do what Jesus would do. That would make you very successful. Well, I've shown that I am unashamedly a woman of excellence and integrity, unashamedly. And I think everybody who calls himself a Christian should be unashamed of excellence and integrity. That is what we need to live by.